This is One on One. Hi, I'm Steve Adubato here at our Lincoln Center studio. I'm honored to introduce Gayle King, who is the co-host of CBS This Morning and editor-at-large at, the Oprah Magazine. It is an honor and pleasure to have you at our Tisch WMT studio.
That's how I feel about being here. It's an honor to be here, Steve, at the Tisch studio. I'm just wondering, did you forget to pay the heating bill? Shall I leave you a credit card, check, a couple of bucks? It is freezing in here.
Yeah, we should let folks know that you can't. Maybe you can see it. Could you see the coming out of our? It's about 50. Terry's about 54 degrees, something like that.
Yes, I'm going to say if you have hot flashes, come to Steve's and we'll totally get rid of them. So thank you.
Well, thank you for being here and enduring.
I'm thrilled to be here.
You do have a great life. We were just talking about this. A typical day in the life of Gayle King is you get up at.
Yep, the alarm goes off at 3:30. I lay there for a second, just reflecting on the day. I actually get up and bathe, Steve. I bathe every day, use deodorant and everything. Car picks me up at 4:30, and then it's off to the races.
You get there to the CBS studio.
So then I'm there at CBS studio. We have meetings before the show. We go over the show. I do hair and makeup because it takes a couple hours to look this cute. You know, when I wake up,
That's your team over there?
This is not the finished product. Yeah, Charlie's very good with hair.
Josh.
Yeah, that is the team, me, Charlie, and Nora.
That's right.
And, so then after we get off the air, we have a meeting, and then I go to my second job, which is at the Oprah Magazine, and we've been doing that since year 2000, so this is year 12. So knock on wood, I'm thinking, really, no, don't cry for me, Argentina, so far so good.
You see, you don't complain. I mean, some people say, wow, that's a lot of hours, that's a lot of pressure, and you say?
It is, but how can you possibly complain when you get to do this kind of work? And we get to meet, and listen, I'm not talking, you know exactly what I'm talking about. You get to meet the people we get to meet, talk to the people we get to talk to, go the different places. What is there to complain about, really? I don't get enough sleep, okay.
You know, it's so true. We get ready. First of all, this studio is a great place for us because you get a lot of folks who might not otherwise have the chance to come to our Jersey studio across the river, folks who, because it's more accessible
location.
Here. Because put it this way, on the other half of the show, we have Ed Asner. Not bad.
Oh, I know.
Not bad, right?
Mr. Grant.
Right?
Yeah, that's how I know him.
Let me ask you, can we go back to the 70s?
Mr. Grant.
Can we go back to the 70s?
Yes, let's.
People may not
let's
know.
Let's go, Steve.
Your extensive career in broadcasting.
Yeah.
Before they see you every morning on the CBS morning show, talk about how you started, where you started. It was not in Baltimore.
No, you know, my first job was in Washington. I went to University of Maryland, majored in psychology, had nothing to do with journalism, and just sort of, I was working in a newsroom. I got hooked in the newsroom. I got hooked with TV news.
What was it?
They had a breaking news story. Steve, it was a breaking news story, and I was so excited by the hustle and bustle and watching everybody run around and be the first person to tell you something. I just thought, I was a production assistant at the time, you know, where I'm saying, Steve, do you need any chyrons? You know, do you have your scripts ready? You know, I was that kid. And I just became fascinated with the process of putting the news together and being the first person to tell you something. You know, I love that you can go to bed at night and you can wake up the next day and the world can be totally changed. And when you turn on your TV, sometimes we are the first person to tell you something. I get high off of that. That to me is such a natural high. So, you know, I went to University of Maryland. I went to Baltimore as a production assistant / writer. Went back to D.C. as a reporter trainee.
Whoa. What was the on-camera thing always for you?
My first on-camera job was in Kansas City, Missouri.
You went out there?
Yeah.
Was it back in the day where they used to tell us, hey, you want to get on air, you have to go to a quote-unquote smaller market?
But that's true. That's still true.
Media markets changed a lot, but that's still true.
I absolutely think that's
true. Go ahead.
I was just talking to somebody, a young person at CBS came to me and asked me, you know, they're interested in getting on air. What do they suggest? And I love people. And I said, well, number one, you ain't going to be able to start at CBS
and
get an on-air job.
Not in New York.
I was going to say, you can't really even start in New York. When I first started, I took out the broadcast yearbook. There are 212 markets in the country. I sat there with that broadcast yearbook. I said, I don't want to go past this Missouri River. I wanted to stay on the East Coast. I looked at from 1 to 30. I knew I couldn't get in the top 10. I thought maybe I could do 20 to 30. And then I said, I want to go to a market that has a sports team because I believe sports gives an energy to a city, even if you're not into sports. So I applied to all these places and I ended up in Kansas City, which at the time had 3 sports teams. I moved to Kansas City. I got a job. I was hired. I got involved in Big Brothers Big Sisters. And, you know, then, you know, that's where my career really started, in Kansas City, Missouri, 1979.
And you meet your friend who has had a fairly, her career has been somewhat.
What's my friend's name?
It really hasn't been that impressive career, but
she's doing all right.
You meet Oprah Winfrey.
We met in Baltimore,
right?
Yes.
Now, our president emeritus, Bill Baker.
Yes.
Right? See the
my
connection?
Gosh, yes.
7 degrees.
6 degrees of separation.
Not even 7 degrees. I got that wrong,
Six
Kevin
degrees.
Bacon. Sorry.
Six degrees. Because Bill Baker hired Oprah for Westinghouse at WJZ.
He sat right in that chair 2 months ago telling the same story, and he told us about you too. So here's the deal. He hires her. You're that in that whole world.
We know Bill Baker,
Did you connect right away with her?
You know, I did, because we were 21 and 22 at the time. We're now 57 and 58, but we were both young, single. We're still black. We were still, we had a lot of like
Funny,
philosophies.
I hadn't noticed.
I'm actually cinnamon brown with a dollop of caramel. But we had a lot of similar interest. All kidding aside, we had a lot of similar interest. And we just connected. We were friends. We were friends practically right away. And of course, we've been friends ever since.
And as you go on with your media career, you're doing all sorts of things. She's doing her thing. As you're moving forward, as the media landscape's changing, are you saying to yourself, because in so many ways, you've achieved so much throughout your career, but in many ways, you're at, I don't want to say you're really on the top, but you are really on the top of your game right now. Why?
I still feel that I'm a work in progress. I don't care how good you are or how good you think you are. There is always something to learn. I really do believe that. And I approach every day that way. You know, am I having a great life? Do I think I'm doing okay? I absolutely do. But I also know that there's always ways to get better, always. So I never sit and think, okay, there's nothing more to accomplish. You're really at the top. I don't look at it that way. I still feel that I can do better, be better, even as great as this is. Listen, I'm working at CBS Morning News. I could have never dreamed this dream for myself.
They came to you.
Yeah, they can't. Listen.
What do you think they saw?
Believe me, I wasn't calling them saying, hello, CBS, I'm here.
What do you think, and again, our mutual friend, Chris Licht over there, your executive producer I worked with at MSNBC, great guy.
Yeah.
Great energy
Very smart guy.
What do you think it is they saw in you to do morning TV? Because you and Charlie and the other was, on paper, I thought, that's an interesting combination.
No, Steve. Okay, let's be for real.
Go ahead.
When you first heard that they were doing Charlie Rose and Gayle King, didn't you go, what?
Yes.
And then was your second
But then I watched, and I thought, this is interesting.
No, you
And I don't want to watch again.
No, I think people went, Then they went, Then they went,
Okay, right. But there's something there. Did you feel it right away?
Well, I feel that we have two different styles. I knew Charlie socially because, you know, I'd seen him out and about. You know, and Charlie Rose, of course, is a legend and an icon.
Sure he is.
So, you know, I didn't personally know him. But, you know, when we started working together, I think we get a kick out of each other, to be honest with you. I think we get a kick out of each other. I think that there are some days that he sits there and he goes, what just happened?
Right.
Then there are other days where he'll go, this is really a lot of fun. And I feel the same about him. There really is nobody like him. Chris, let's go back to Chris Licht. You know, you said, what did he see? You know, he was a big muckety muck at Morning Joe.
Sure he was.
And they would have me on Morning Joe. You know, they always have a cast of characters coming in. And I think he saw something in my exchanges with Mika and Joe that was different than other people. And he took it to CBS, and CBS said, oh, okay, well, she certainly wasn't something we thought about, but maybe. And then, you know, I had meetings with them, and then the rest is January 9th, 2012. There we are.
One more question, Gayle, about the TV side before we go to the magazine side. The key to morning television, because obviously there's lots of competition with the Today Show, and the ABC show's not doing bad either.
Oh, no. Right? Good Morning America's kicking butt, no question.
What do you believe most people are looking for when they wake up early in the morning and they turn on one station or the other?
I think they have to be comfortable with the people that they're watching. If they don't like you, if they're not interested in you, it doesn't matter how good you are. People want to feel connected to the people they're watching in the morning. That really is number one. And then after that, they have to like the format of the show. They have to feel that not only are they comfortable with you, but they have to feel that the people who are on the air are comfortable with each other.
Yeah, do they have to believe you like each other?
I think they have to feel that you all don't mind hanging out together, yes.
And that's not fake.
Well,
over that many hours,
it's
hard to be fake.
I can't fake it, Charlie can't fake it, and I know Nora can't fake it. So, you know, and if you are faking it, I think the audience senses that. So they have to believe that the three, the two of you, however you do it, you know, at Channel, I was going to say at Channel 3, back to my local days, at CBS I say we have a menage a trois. They have to feel that you two, that the three of you get along. Mm. And I think that they sense that. I think they sense that.
Some of the keys to, oh, the Oprah Magazine. By the way, I love your column there. It's very personal.
Yeah, the world according to Gayle, we looked high and low. What shall we call that, Steve?
I love it. Can I tell you one of the ones I really like here as I was going through this? Because we have something else in common.
What?
Right? Other than the fact that I'm from Newark and I know you're a big fan of Cory Booker.
Yes,
that's my hometown.
No, I love Cory Booker.
No kidding.
Not big fan. I love him.
No kidding. Yeah. But you're also a big fan of Boardwalk Empire. Because you talked about Stephen Buscemi there.
Yes.
You're excited about. I love Boardwalk Empire. Why do you love it?
Oh, my gosh. Because Nucky Thompson, you never know what he's going to do. And here is a guy who looks, you know, sort of like an ordinary guy who is like a badass.
Bad.
He's with the women,
yeah.
With the men.
Yeah.
You know, he's not like he's a big strapping guy, but he's such a good actor that you get caught up in it. You know, my new discovery is Homeland. I just discovered Homeland and Downton Abbey. And I like Breaking Bad.
Breaking Bad is good.
Breaking Bad is really good, really good.
And you're not, real quick, 1 minute left. Are you a fan of, we had Andy Cohn sitting right in that seat not too long ago.
Oh, you know I love him.
Come on, Housewives, the Housewives series, no? Talk about going from PBS to downstream.
I don't know anything about Carolyn, Teresa, Melissa.
Look at you.
I don't know anything
you
about
those
guys.
You gave that up.
No.
Just by knowing. You love.
I know nothing about them.
So to recap, you love getting up at 3:30 in the morning.
Caroline, the Countess.
Yes, don't start talking about
Ramona.
The LA. Oh, stop. I've had enough Pinot Grigio. So here it is.
Pinot Grigio.
Yeah, see, the fact that I know scares me.
Don't
it's
be tardy to the party.
That song is.
Okay.
This is PBS. We just only do that for research.
Sorry,
here's the deal.
Steve,
to recap, you love getting up at 3:30. You take the bath right after that.
I didn't say I love it.
Hygiene's important. You take the bath right after that. The car picks you up at 4:30.
Yes.
You're there with Charlie and Nora after that. You do that. Then you go to O and you kick butt over there. You got the great magazine going. You love your life.
Yes, I do.
Mark Cuban was recently on your show. And he said.
Mark Cuban said back in 2008, if he died and he could come back, if he could come back as anybody, he'd want to come back as him. I asked him the other day, does that still hold true in 2012? He goes, even more so. That ain't a bad thing to say about yourself.
Love it. Listen, every day people can see you. Time again?
CBS This Morning from 7 to 9, and I come on at 8. You should start watching at 7.
Listen, you're terrific. We appreciate
thank you,
being
Steve.
Here.
Thank you. That's very nice of you.
Doesn't it warm up a little bit?
I was just going to say, you took the words out of my mouth. It's warming up.
Gayle, it's an honor to have you. A pleasure.
No, I feel that too. Thank
you. All the best.
Thank you very much.
People ask why you love your job here at PBS and all of our great shows.
We love our job.
Will you get out of the camera?
Okay.
See, when Gayle's in the shot.
We love our job.
See?
Okay, sorry.
This is why I love my job. We'll be right back right after this from the Tisch WNET Studios at the beautiful Lincoln Center. Thank you, Gayle.
Beautiful.
One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation. Celebrating 25 years of broadcast excellence. This special edition of One-on-One with Steve Adubato is brought to you from the Tisch WNET Studios at Lincoln Center. Funding has been provided by Hackensack University Medical Center, Berkeley College, TD Bank, QualCare Inc., a local managed care company covering 750,000 New Jersey residents. The law firm of Gibbons PC, Verizon Communications, and by the Russell Berry Foundation. Promotional support provided by the Star Ledger and NJ.com, Everything Jersey, and by the New Jersey Business and Industry Association and its monthly magazine, New Jersey Business. Transportation provided by Airbrook Limousine, serving the metropolitan New York, New Jersey area. One-on-One with Steve Adubato has been produced in partnership with St. Joseph's Healthcare System.